here we are, guys. This is the last part of the how to use my Tier 2 advancement ticket. First, I want to thank you for for being patient with my English so far. I'm really trying to give you the opportunity here to learn of how to use your Tier 2 wisely, and where to acquire it, and for which character, and where to acquire those characters, and all those kind of stuff. So if you just came here and you don't know what I am talking about, I have three more parts of how to use your Tier 2 advancement ticket. If you don't know what is the Tier 2 advancement ticket, is this item over here, where you could just get it with diamonds by spending crystals, with a lot different options, but I didn't give any option there because it is really hard to get. And the easiest way, it is this, with this kind of event, where we say in the last part, in the third part, there is an event going on the after the mid-month, basically before the mid-month, sorry, again, where we have to the option to buy this Tier 2 advancement ticket with 700 points, where you are able to progress and acquire through those 13 days, and when it ends, we have the next update, the mid-month update, okay? So in today's part, we will talk about the world boss. This is one of the hardest stages right now into the game. And also we will talk about the giant boss raid, the the GBR we have right now, and the, one of the ways we can acquire CTPs. I know it is something like impossible to get one, but it is something like, it also give you premium card tokens, and you are in a position to get a free premium card at least once a month. I will start with GBR because it is simple. The only characters that helps you right now are the support characters. You have so many free options out there, you don't really need any Tier 2 dealer, like Luna, like Namor. You have ton of characters that may help you here. The top 10 characters are Nick Fury, White Fox, basically all of the supports that you can acquire. So if you have any of the premium characters, premium support characters, I suggest you to really directly upgrade them to Tier 2 character, because they will help you a lot, and to not struggle defeat this world boss. Even Galactus can be easily be destroyed by characters like Saren Roger. Saren Roger is one of the best clearer over here. So with the help of Nick Fury and White Fox, she may be able to one shot, not at least two shot, Galactus, if she is well built. So I suggest you to get to, if you want and focus on the GBR, I suggest you to focus on the support type of characters. You have the list on the first video of the first part, so you will know where to acquire any of the characters. Okay, I will go directly on the world boss. So the world boss is something like a two-part world boss over here. We have all of the world bosses, the villain world bosses and the hero world bosses, and after that we have Null. We will let Null a little bit later. I will talk more about the regular bosses. Basically not regular, the ultimate world bosses, because the normal and the beginner, it is so easy that I don't think you need any premium character to upgrade to finish this one. I think even Iron Man level 60 can do it without any CTP. Maybe with Obelisk 100% he is able to do it with just attacks. Anyway, every world boss has his own difficulties, but Here I have a list of the characters that will help you with the world boss. Now you will see characters with frame. Those characters are for null, so that is why I told you that we will let null for later. So as you see here, I have characters that is supporters and dealers. In the supporters, I have the premium characters that can be used as a leadership. So I do not suggest you to go directly for an example and advanced tier 2 Enchantress. I was remembering the other name of Enchantress. So that is why I added over there the skin Enchantress, because she's able to also deal damage with her skill. She's able to one shot, if you're not familiar with it. I have ton of videos over there. So I have the leadership characters, I have the all defense down characters, I have the buff characters. I will really explain you what is this all about. So if you need the character to directly finish easily the world boss and you don't want to struggle with, you really need weapon hex. You will tell me what weapon hex will do. I will show you right away. So I will go to the Mo, for an example 99 states, okay? We are able to do it with better build, okay? I will go with support to do it. I'm going with White Fox and Phylavel. I think this is, yeah, this is the best team. Usually we use until the level 90 this kind of team, okay? So, as strikers, we have all of those characters. We don't really need them. It is just for an upgrade of better ability to do more 10 damage and more 12 damage and more 12 damage. So we have 30% more damage with the strikers. This is not this kind of the video, but this is why I tell you that the best choice for here it is weapon hex. So I will go without weapon hex for now, so you see what I'm going to do, okay? So as you know, better build is one of the best characters, and with those kind of two kind of supporters, he's probably to, you know, to do a lot of damage, right? But this is all not all he needs. So we are going here. We will go from his back, and we will do the and let's see the damage he will do. So as you see over here, better build has only 50% minus 50% all defense down, and this is the damage he did only by himself. Let's try to use White Fox as a leadership skill that gives with this the uniform all defense down and all debuffs, sorry, effect by 40% increase. So the all defense down we did, sorry, it will increase by 40%, so it will give us around 20 more percent. So with this one we have to change the character and do the same again like we did before. So we did a little bit more damage, but we are at 70% right now, so that is why we didn't do it again. Because we really need to be this to be 100%. Let's see the difference with having weapon hex as a striker. So I will add only weapon hex, right? Just that. If you want the striker to directly attack, you have to co-op. I think you know that already, right? So we will go like that again, from behind his back, co-op 3, 5, 4 and 6. And you will see that battery build is going boom. Look the difference, guys. Look the difference. With just a simple character, we are able to one-shot a 99-stage world boss. Oh my god! I will go with the team. I'm using the Ghost Rider over here. So, as you see on the list, Teenage Warhead is one of the characters that can also all defense down. We have two options: to use them as a team, where the all defense down skill can be activated by co-oping and activate a team bonus, like the Emma Frost and Warhead over here. So if we join, we will see that when I co-op on the skill, they will use the skill that they have on the team bonus. Okay, so that is why I'm telling you all of those kind of characters are worth to upgrade. For an example, you will see over here Ghost Rider without his uniform was really nothing. He wasn't able to do anything really. So right now he is able at least to do something. So as you see over here, we have just one character to all defense down. Right now, it is not that my Ghost Rider is one of the best characters into the game, so I cannot, you know, showcase Ghost Rider on 99 stage. But I will show you something else, okay? I didn't want to make it in this kind of video, but I will show you right away. So in the 70 stage level, because I don't have the valor to increase the stage like that, we are able to do it, yes. I think only with weapon hex. Sometimes I use some more strikers just to be sure I can do it, to increase the valor further, but I will try to do it only with weapon hex right now. So just look at this. He did it. I just didn't proc in the right time. He did it. He did one shot the world boss. After some tries, you will be familiar with it and you will be in a position to one-shot every single boss. Some bosses, as you know, they have some requirements, like they have a lot of physical immunity or magic immunity, so you have to use other characters. So we really can do it. I'm doing this all of the time. You really sometimes need the Dr. Saints to freeze the boss so he will be in a position to die without phasing onto the next stage. So that was the video, guys. I really don't want to confuse you and be in more of detail, because I think you already understand the situation. So the buffs, as you saw, it is characters like White Fox. We are using them not only as a leader, but also because of their passive and skills that help our characters to progress further. The defense down characters is the characters that we can use as strikers or as a team bonuses, where they can activate their all defense down. And the leadership characters, you can use them as leader to increase the damage you are doing, or by increasing the physical energy or increasing the debuff duration. And the dealers are also characters that deal a lot of damage, sometimes not one-shotting, but most of them can really one-shot all of the world bosses. And I'm telling not every single boss, because some of them are you know, have resist on physical and magical, as we said. So some characters that are not hybrid characters, like for an example Professor X, where he has elemental type skills and maybe can do both physical and energy resistant world bosses. We will get in more detail later, but yeah, you got the point, right? So now we will go for the null side. As you know, Null works only with Awaken and entire 3 characters, so really you have to upgrade all of the characters you can to deal and progress and at least make 5 teams. Right now we have a few of the premium characters that they are able to help us in this stage, so by help us I mean they have to be upgraded to Awakening state or tier 3 state to be able to at least help us kill the null. So I chose for the leadership skill Crescent because of the combat type physical increasement skill that she has. Also I use Ares for the physical increasement that he has, because except I think Hulk and Winter Soldier, I don't think we have anyone else for increasing physical attack out there. After that we have for the mind damage the Professor X. Maybe he will use it for himself, maybe sometimes for the Jean Grey. I don't know who mind damage user are you using over there, but he will be in a big use right there. For the buff skills we have and the big damage dealers, believe me, we have those buff characters, Valkyria and Mystique. If you really want support characters, those two are the best right now into the game, because Null is a villain type character, so both of them has increased damage on the villain type characters. If you are struggling a little bit and you are getting a lot of damage from the Null, Valkyria will help you out, because with the new uniform she is able, with not only the ignore dodge that she got, but with the decreased damage where you receive, to easily pawn null. So the best damage dealers are the guys that you see over there for the premium characters, right? Really, don't confuse yourself, there are also a lot of free characters like Moon Knight, Sarah Roger, I see Iron Man over there, so yeah, there are a lot of options. You don't have to go with premium only. So that was the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I really hope that helped you out. It's really happy for me. I'm really happy to help people understand the tactics of the game. If you want to see more videos of world bosses, I have a lot of one-shot world bosses. I will do a lot of one-shot. I think every single character into the game is able to do one-shot with a proper team. So I will try to do as more as I can. So be sure to follow the channel so you don't miss any, you know, video you may interest of, you know, to see. So I hope you enjoy it. If you really enjoy it, don't forget to like and subscribe to see more videos like that. Until the next video, guys, see you soon.